My objective with this piece was to try to challenge myself and to create a more gritty and realistic concept from what I normally do. Second, to use a more soft and subtle lighting situation. And third, to include environmental storytelling. I'll be inspired by The Walking Dead, Destiny, and The Last of Us on PS4. Now this painting won't come out good without a proper plan, so my strategy is to first use Google SketchUp to create a quick mock-up for scene layout. I will then export that to view for a render, and then a hell of a lot of photo bashing on top. Hello everyone, so I wanted to try something a bit new with this video. You know when you see online, you know, some image that you really like, and you just want to get into that headspace of the artist to see what they were thinking or feeling or how, you know, in their mind they constructed it? Well, that's kind of what this is for, in case anyone by some means is interested in the image I just put out. I thought I'd just do a little video blog type thing about it. So well, first of all, this painting was really exhausting for me to make. Do you guys think I hit any of those goals I set forth for myself? Most of you know from my existing work, you know, that follow me, that I usually go with kind of heavily saturated images with bright colors and definitely more painterly and whimsical in feeling. So achieving this very subtle type of lighting was rather difficult for me. I was really just going for this situation where the clouds had just kind of dispersed a little and the sun is just peeking through that small break in them. So we get a little bit of that lighting just gently kind of hitting that gate, you know, the focal point of the area. And it's just after it rained and everything, so having the puddles on the ground and everything should kind of complete that effect. So when I set out to do this painting and I actually began making it initially, I didn't really have a set direction that I was going to do with the narration on it or the storytelling. I knew I wanted to do some type of quarantine checkpoint type scene. And so that's when I kind of came up with the title on the whim, The First to Go. I just thought it'd be interesting to have some hazmat type soldiers kind of escorting out, you know, these two young children, you know, a brother and a sister. So really, we don't know, you know, from the get-go, what type of biohazard type situation is happening here, but we just know as the viewer that these children are being removed from that situation for one reason or another. And the idea was just kind of to have me keep the viewer questioning, why is this all happening? Are they being extracted to safety? Perhaps these two children's DNA or something kind of, you know, Hollywood like that, hold the key to salvation and can save mankind. Or perhaps these children are the roots of the disease or virus or something that's breaking out inside and they were kind of pinpointed by some kind of scanners and now they're taken to be executed. But it was really about kind of depicting this true moment of uncertainty and just leaving lots of subtle cues and hints throughout the scene. And that's what I meant by having that other goal of environmental storytelling in there. Having the environment being, you know, a bit overgrown and, you know, trees kind of sprouting out, and it was in an urban environment, right? So it had to at least show kind of 20 years since the collapse of some type of normal society. There's really been no true advances in modern technology or anything like that, considering I kind of just made these soldiers more or less modern day today. And I wanted to put, you know, that Gate 05 on there, really just to show that there's a few different, you know, inputs, outputs to the city, but they're all heavily monitored by military personnel, so nobody's getting in or out, and it's basically a situation you or I do not want to be in. I've always just really been intrigued by, you know, these biohazard situations, societal collapses, and kind of post-apocalyptic scenarios. And really, one of the more difficult aspects of this painting for me personally was to kind of get away from or adjusting the use of such, you know, heavy use of photography or photos, you know, when I photo bash the scene up. It's quite, you know, to some degree or another, every inch was originally covered with a photo or two. And I had to kind of go back, as, you know, some artists kind of call it covering my tracks, and I wanted to give it a little bit, I wanted to loosen it up, sprinkle a bit of life into it, and kind of just kind of get rid of that blocky photo type of look. And in parts of it are more successful than others in this painting, but it was really kind of difficult for me to integrate the characters that way so seamlessly into this scene, because they more or less were direct photos. I only had to paint very few bits of them into the scene, you know, particularly with the feet and everything, to make it look really kind of cohesive. But overall, I did enjoy painting this. It was a lot of work and kind of mentally more straining than some of the normal things that I typically do, but I definitely wouldn't want to paint like this every time, but I would definitely give it another go. So if I could pass on any tips or other suggestions to other artists based off of my experience in this scene, it would be to definitely have full control over every element you put in a scene. Everything should have a meaning and a purpose. You're the creator of your own work after all, so if something is just in there for the sake of it being in there, remove it. A majority of the times, it's just always better to simplify. If you enjoyed this painting and would like to learn the techniques and principles on how to create similar concepts, I have a 2-hour full-length tutorial I will sell for $8. It covers the creating quick 3D mockups, referencing, photo bashing, and overpainting techniques. Be sure to subscribe to my mailing list for discounts and info when it's available. So this was my new art show idea. If you liked it, let me know. If you didn't and thought I wasted my time, also let me know. I'm interested in what everyone has to say. Also, if this is your first time finding me, I also offer 2 other art shows, the Brush Sauce Theater, which kind of covers art techniques, principles, and the Brush Sauce Theater Contest, where Adam Duff and I critique our monthly challenges. Thank you for watching and subscribing. Take care.